us that they've not implemented any budget for themselves for 1 year. So we are coming to remind them that we know what they did and we have not forgotten and we will not forget.
Me on my leg. So when I look front, look the person that shot me, it was Adetun Brighton. It was a police officer because I used to sew police uniform. I'm a fashion designer. So even when they shot me, they were still beating me. So the Ade that shot me was still telling a fellow people that if I die, they will bury me at the back of the station. So they beat me before some guys come rush me to hospital. When I was in hospital, they didn't even bother to even come. After, before they sent one of them to come and write some statements, before they left. Since then, I didn't see them. I have spent almost 1.7 million on this leg. No issue now. They fixed iron on this leg before. So, it was last month I removed the iron because I was not seeing any improvement. So I went to native home to go and be treating it now. That's where I am now. The money they even tell me now, I've not even paid yet. So I'll be suffering a lot. I'll be suffering. Even my store have closed. No work again. I don't have any money. Nothing. I'm just alone with my mother. Finish.
So what's the appeal right now to the government?
They should help me because I don't have anything anymore. They should help me. I need help. I need money. I want to work. I want to face my life, face my future. So I need money. I need money. I need help for the government.
I was one of those panel members that represent NSAS in Edo State Judicial Panel. Today we are crying to the world to see, using this case of Stephen Miracle, Ogezua, and even Osasuna guy that they shot during our protest in this museum. In those cases, because we are NSAS representative, we know how we push for the army that shot, that was deployed to quell that protest, for them to be brought to book during our panel plenary. We did everything. The lawyer fought. First, they said that it was the GOC commanding Auchi division. Command, we did everything. No, that one there was not showing up. Later, they now said that it's in Ibadan. We sent a letter to Ibadan, they didn't show up. Later, they now said Abuja. We sent a letter to Abuja, they didn't show up. Everything we did for the Nigeria and me to come and respond to this allegation, they refused. But after that, after all said and done, then the panel report was submitted. And I personally lobbied of my NSAS caucus that, using what happened in Ondo State, that most of these people, Miracle, Stephen, and the rest of others, should be given automatic employment because they are you can see the visible disability they have. We appeal to the state government, Godunob Baseki, please give these children a second chance to live. They were just exercising their fundamental rights, which is protest. I don't see protest was peaceful. Up to this moment. Our panel report in Edo State, I've not even been submitted to Abuja.
No white paper,
nothing. All the policemen, civil defense, DSS, and some other group of people that was indicted in this moment, none of them have been brought to book.
We are here today to mark our day. Today is Youth Day, and we are sounding it very clear to our leaders. Whether they like it or not, this country they must face. There is one thing I have always come to remind them, and that thing is debt. Our leaders today across board, from federal, state to local governments, there is none that is not above 40 years. So invariably, if they must live on Mother Earth, they will not live up to 50 years. Now, when they go, who will they leave Nigeria for? They should put that at the back of their mind. You can steal a mass wealth for yourself, a mass wealth for your family, but definitely you are going to leave Mother Earth someday, sometime. Your children will be wherever they find themselves. We Nigerians will be here. So it is high time our leaders must wake up to their responsibility. They should fix Nigeria. What Edo youth is crying for, what Nigeria youth is crying for, is very simple. All our federal roots, fix them. For the state government, fix our state road. For the local government, play your part. Then for light, it takes nothing to give Nigeria power. Give Nigeria light. Let them develop themselves. Just give us light, give us our roads, give us good roads. Then for our youth, those that are employable, employ them.
We are here today in memorial of the fallen heroes. They might have forgotten, but we've not forgotten what happened October 20, 2020. We are not cowards. Do you know that 1 year later, the government has not done nothing about the NSAS victims and the SAS victims that made people to protest? 1 year later, they have not done anything. And they are telling us they are not scam. This government is pure scam. Are they going to tell us that they have not implemented any budget for themselves for 1 year? So we are coming to remind them that we know what they did and we have not forgotten. And we will not forget.